grow a beard, a massive, full, epic, thick beard on your face. Today, I want to talk about growing a beard, an epic, massive, thick, full beard on your face. A lot of people have been commenting on my beard, and I think it's pretty fun and it's pretty great, and you know, people are having a good time and humor with it. Like, here's one comment from Ontario Homesteader. And so that got me to thinking it might be fun to make a video talking about growing a beard. And I haven't had a beard my whole life. I started and I've had played with the mustache and played with the little upside down V thing underneath the lip and had a kind of a goatee thing for a long, long time. And then when we moved here to the homestead, I thought, hey, we're living on a homestead and what can I do to be more homesteady? And it seemed like quitting shaving would be the smart thing to do. And so that's what I decided to do, is throw away the razors and just not shave. So here are my five, you know, facts, tips, steps, ideas, whatever you want to call them, about how you can grow a beard. So number one, I think is the, you know, pretty obvious, but we got to say it, stop shaving. Stop. Don't shave at all. Just throw away your razors and don't shave. A lot of guys start growing their beard and after a week or two, you know, they got some thin spots here under the lip. I'm pretty lucky. Mine's always been real thick there, but thin on the sides, whatever. Or you got the little stray hairs and you think, I'm going to touch it up and shave and I'm going to trim it. Don't do that. Don't touch it for at least 30 days, even like 40 or 45 days or better. Just let it grow. And that's the important step number one. Step two, think of your skincare. Hey, us guys, we're not too much into that stuff. But once the hair starts growing, you've got to think about the skin that's underneath the hair. So ladies, you can help your guy out here with skin cleansers, keeping the skin good and clean, moisturizers, rubbing it in there, you know, so the skin's good and moist so that it'll be healthy. So guys, don't be afraid to ask your ladies for a little skincare help on keeping it moisturized and clean, and then it'll be better for you. Number three, itchy. We all go through that itchy phase. It might be a couple of days, a week, 2 weeks, whatever, but at some point, the face is gonna start to get itchy. Now, step number two, helps with step number three of the itchy phase. But if you, you just gotta put up with it. Just keep yourself busy, keep yourself occupied, do whatever you need to do. And try your best to ignore that itchy phase. Don't say, oh, I've had it, I'm gonna start, you know, I gotta shave, this isn't for me, I'm never ever gonna be able to grow a beard, this itch is just driving me crazy. Just hang in there and go day by day, and I promise that eventually the itch will go away. Number four, a beard is good for you. I mean, think about it. The beard covers up the skin, so it keeps your skin warmer in the winter time. You know, you see the guys with all the snow and icicles and everything. It protects you in the winter. In the summer, if we ever got any sunshine around here, it's just raining all the time, it protects you from the sun. And so it's kind of like having SPF 20 or something like that on your skin. So if you're out in the sun all the time, having facial hair will protect your skin. So that's a great thing. And in the wintertime, again, with the ice and the snow. So it's healthy for you. So maybe that's an idea that can help you and your lady agree to having the beard, is that it's healthy and good for you. And of course, number one, the most important step at all, it's manly, it's masculine. Guys look more manly with beards. And women like their men manly. At least that's what I read in all those magazines. that women like manly men. You look more masculine, you look buffer and that. So all you do is you get yourself a nice little flannel shirt, buy yourself a hat, grow yourself out a nice full beard, and then you're raring to go. Thick beard, just let it grow. And I do trim it a little on the edge, the little loose hairs, but hey, you just want to let it go. I do trim my mustache. I've always trimmed that for all the years and years and years that I had the goatee before that I had the full beard. I trim the mustache hairs. The other way is a lot of guys don't even trim the mustache hairs. They just train them over and just let them grow. So that's up to you. Jeez. I kind of liked it yesterday when our road was completely flooded and there were cars stuck in the water because it was quiet. I don't know why. It's one of those busy days today. Yeah, so grow your manly beard thick. Just let it grow. It will fill in, you know, a stray hair here or there. Don't shave for the first 30 to 45 days and the ladies will like it. You'll like it. It's all about being happy, fun-loving, and carefree on your homestead, in the suburbs, in the city, wherever you live. Be a manly man with a thick beard. If you have a friend that's thinking about growing a beard, or ladies, maybe you want your guy to grow a beard and he's not too much into it, share this video with that person. And hopefully it'll help you and help them out and help educate them to growing a beard. So share it. Living happy, living fun-loving, and of course, living carefree.